I welcome all subscribers and guests of the channel trying to maintain their electronic equipment on their own. Today I will share with you two life hacks for such a service, using the example of restoring the functionality of the tablet buttons. At first, the power button on this tablet failed. And for a long time the function of this button was performed by a case with a built-in magnet. But then the volume control buttons also failed. So I had no choice but to make this simple repair. And so, the first life hack, these are the keys with which I open any latch devices. I made them from polyvinyl chloride, which, by the way, is one of the starting materials in the production of sewer pipes. This material is softer than polypropylene, but it does not leave marks on delicate plastic cases. Unfortunately, after each use, the key has to be put in order with a file. When repairing products with built-in batteries, first of all we turn off the power. It is worth noting that any connectors must be handled very carefully, since in the event of a breakdown, finding a new connector can be problematic. And special equipment may be required to replace modern miniature connectors. If there is a danger of accidental shorting, it is better to isolate the power connector in any convenient way. Modern flex cables are made of Kapton, so they are not afraid of high temperatures. But in this case, everything turned out to be not so simple. Glue was applied between the flex cable and the PCB. Ethyl alcohol can be used to dissolve some adhesives. However, refrain from using other solvents unless urgently needed. Also, when dismantling, it is advisable to use an alcohol rosin flux, which, evaporating, lowers the temperature of flex cable. And in order to distribute heat over the entire contact area, you can use wood's metal or Rose's metal. The melting temperature of these alloys is 65 and 95 degrees Celsius, respectively. And here is the second life hack. To restore the work of the so-called tactile buttons, we need an eraser to remove ink. With the help of a sharp knife, we should give shape it something like this. Now gently pry up the scotch tape to get to the contact domes or bevel springs, if you are more familiar with that name. My modest experience in restoring buttons for tablets, phones and cameras allows us to assert that an oxide layer with an increased ohmic resistance is formed only along the perimeter of the contact dome. Therefore, it is this surface that must be cleaned. In the central part of the dome, the contact is never broken. In any case, I have not yet encountered such malfunctions. Typically, tactile switches of this design can work for a long time. A malfunction occurs if a Chinese manufacturer decides to use unsuitable metals or coatings in the button, which leads to the formation of a galvanic pair. The presence of the product in the tropics, and especially in the tropics by the ocean, where humid air contains high levels of salt and iodine, also significantly reduces the MTBF. Sometimes the adhesive tape that holds the contact domes becomes unusable. Do not be afraid of this. It can be replaced with any scotch tape, although it is better to use some branded product. Poor quality tape can cause the contact dome to move, causing the button to malfunction. The smallest contacts I have had to restore were in the joysticks of digital cameras. The diameter of the contact dome was only 3 millimeters there. As you noticed, I removed the oxide film for a very long time and carefully, but still, before assembling, it is better to measure the resistance of the contacts with an ohmmeter. In this case, the resistance of the test lead probes used is about 2/10 of an ohm. That is, the resistance of the contacts together with the loop is from 2/10 to 4/10 of ohm. I decided to replace the old double-sided tape, as it did not hold the board with buttons well. I didn't have a special tape and used a regular one from a stationery store. Different types of adhesive tape are often used in modern electronic devices. Make sure you have these consumables on hand before disassembling the product. Before installing the flex cable, you should remove the remnants of glue and flux. It is also necessary to tin the pins on the PCB to ensure the same amount of solder on the surface of these pins. This is a very important condition, especially if we are blind soldering, as in this case. After that, we can finally solder the flex cable. During installation, you should pay attention to the quality of the solder points. They should look uniform and have a characteristic shine. It is advisable to rinse both the solder points and the place around them with alcohol or an alcohol-gasoline mixture, even if you used a neutral flux. Now you can check the quality of the soldering and check the contacts for a short circuit. I wish you a successful repair of electronic equipment. And see you on the channel.